Gennady really wouldn't be where he is, not only in the United States, but internationally, without the help and support of HBO. So on behalf of this promotion, I'd like to introduce Peter Nelson of HBO.
Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you to all the media for coming out today. It's great to see the kind of support that Gennady's fights have come to generate in the press. And for us, it's been a long journey. I remember back when I was a journalist talking with this gentleman right here, Doug Fisher, and we were talking about who the best middleweights in the world were. And Doug said to me that he said, I'm not sure, but I think that Gennady Golovkin may be the best pound for pound, maybe in any division, not just middleweight. But we need to see him tested, and we need to see that scene. And it took some time before he could make it onto HBO. And with each successive event that we did, we saw fans respond. So even though he would go into fights sometimes a 2-1 favorite, a 3-1 favorite, we'd always try to find the best available guy to fight him. But the fans respected that every test that was put in front of him, he tried his best to put on a show. With many fighters in boxing, fans can hope to be entertained, but with Gennady Golovkin, they can expect to be. And it's the delineating difference between knowing the value of the ticket that you're buying. This fight is, again, a strong test for Gennady. We haven't seen him in against this style of fight before. Ever since he challenged for the title the first time, Gennady knocked out his opponent. He's done so 12 times since. At the world championship level, he has 100% knockout ratio and the longest streak of any champion of which I'm aware. He looks to continue that tradition. On the other side, Willie Monroe is going to look to upend those expectations. For us, we see this as being yet another event in the trajectory of Gennady's career, where we've been asked again and again to find the toughest fight that we can for him. And it's Gennady himself who is driven to try to create those moments. But again and again, we see that opponents, after they can go just past, you know, 7-8 rounds, are celebrating in the locker room that they made it even that far against Gennady Golovkin to get knocked out. So he's a unique fighter, and it's a strong test in front of Willie Monroe. But we fully expect, from what we've seen from his performances on ESPN, that he can rise to that occasion. So I want to thank Artie Palullo and Banner Promotions, Matt Rowland. I want to thank Dina Dufine, everyone at the Forum, Joel Fisher, Sal Federico as well. And I want to say a word about Chocolatito being on this show, because he's another fighter with whom we've tried to architect his debut on HBO for some time. And I had a fuzzy notion a while ago of trying to do a tournament that would be called Lord of the Flyweights. This and other bad boxing puns on a daily basis at the office. But at the end of the day, what we've seen emerge is that Chocolatito Gonzalez presently is the Lord of the Flyweights. And this fight that's in front of him and Edgar Sosa is one of the toughest tests to date. We didn't want to just have a check-of-the-box fight for him when he showed up on the network. We wanted a strong test for him. And we look forward to a strong partnership going forward, because we see in the flyweight division that there's a richness and caliber of fighter, and they don't deserve to be ignored simply because they fight at a lower weight. I don't think that HBO has had a fight at flyweight specifically in about 20 years. We went lower than flyweight, I believe, for Carbajal in 1997. But it's been a long time since we've seen fighters at these weights perform on the network, and we're thrilled and privileged to be able to have them on our platform. So I want to thank, above all, Tom Loeffler for having the vision to put together this show. And I want to thank the fighters and their teams, Gennady, Max and Oleg Harriman, and Abel Sanchez. It's a privilege to work with their team, and we look forward to a great event on May the 16th. Our start time is going to be 9:45 ETPT. We look forward to seeing you all there. Thank you.
Just an anecdote with HBO. When we first went into their offices, probably in February 2012. Peter had a list of fighters, and I have to really say Peter really advocated for Gennady to come on the network because he'd never been on US TV before. He was the WBC, or still is the WBC middleweight champion, but he never really was known over here in the United States, and it really took a push that Peter advocated for to get him on the network. But I'm going to put Peter on the spot here for a minute, and there was like a list of like 20 names, and he just was like throwing them out. Would you fight this guy? Would you fight that guy? Just trying to figure out who would make the most sense at that particular time. And to this day, we've never turned down one name from HBO. Is that correct?
That is correct.
And a lot of that has to do with Abel Sanchez and the vision with Oleg Herman as the manager. I mean, they understand boxing is a sport, but at the same time, it's entertainment. Entertainment is what will sell tickets and get TV ratings. And so Abel understands the style that he trains Gennady in, which is now famously called the Mexican style. But I mean, he understands it's an entertainment sport, you know. And if Gennady, you know, says, well, okay, I'll fight this guy, but I won't fight that guy, and this guy's too tall, or this guy's a southpaw, or whatever it is. I mean, it's really the best available person at that time that's willing to get in the ring with Gennady, and that's clearly Willie Monroe Jr. at this particular time. With that being said, I'd like to bring up Matt Rowland from Banner Promotions.
Hi, everyone. I want to thank the real middleweight champion of the world, Gennady Golovkin, for taking this challenge. I want to thank Tom Boffler, Bernie, K2, and of course HBO, Peter Nelson. I particularly want to thank ESPN. I know it's been talked about up here that Willie's won 4 straight fights on ESPN. If it wasn't for the Boxino tournament, with Brian Queter and John Compagna getting behind it, quite frankly, we wouldn't be here today. So it was one thing for them to give us the dates and to allow us to have the vision of Boxino. But production-wise, they got behind us. They got behind the fighters. Everyone knows the fighters' story. Everyone watched it. Everyone respects Willie. And quite frankly, we need more of it. So I really want to thank, again, Brian and John. They're the best. So I know you guys don't want to hear from me too much, so I'm going to go straight to introducing Tony Morgan, who is the trainer of Willie Monroe. Tony's from Florida. He actually discovered Willie because they brought in Willie as a sparring partner for Andre Berto. Willie was just coming off of his controversial loss to Darnell Boone, and since then he's gone 8-0 under Tony Morgan. So I'd like to bring up Tony.
Hello, how's everybody doing today? I want to thank everybody for putting this together. Peter, HBO, Abel for training Gennady. Gennady for everything he's done. Dana for the venue, Banner, K2 Promotions. Not one to talk a lot. I know a few faces out here in the crowd. We can talk later. We're going to go in on the 16th. We do what we do. We win. Gennady's a tough guy. I think his guy's been formidably picked for him. I think he bit off more than he can chew this time, and I think he'll see that. May the best man win. I wish everybody luck, and like I said, we're going to do what we do. Appreciate you having us.
He is, Willie is undefeated under the tutelage of and the training of Tony Morgan, so that's a great testament to that. And if I'm correct, Matt, it was 2 undefeated fighters that Willie had beaten to win the Boxino tournament. So he's definitely faced some great competition getting to the point where he is right now. He's rated number 2 in the WBA and will definitely be, I think as Peter said, Gennady's never faced a style such as Willie before. He comes from a great pedigree of a lineage of Willie the Worm Monroe, who beat Marvin Hagler as a middleweight in the middleweight division. And Willie the Worm was, you know, great middleweight fighter from Philadelphia, so definitely has the lineage in his family. With that being said, I'd like to bring up trainer who I've known, a person who I've known for a long time, over 20 years now, and who I have a lot of respect for, and I think does a tremendous job for the fighters he works with. And I have to say, Abel was looking at, he built a tremendous compound up in Big Bear Lake and was looking at kind of stepping aside and letting other people rent the facility. And then when Gennady Golovkin walked into his gym with Oleg and Max, he changed his mind and is back in the spotlight right now, working with one of the best fighters in the world today, if not the best. So I want to bring up Abel Sanchez.
Thank you very much for coming out and checking Tom out. On a serious side, I think Tony Morgan is one of the brightest young coaches in the game today. As you know, he developed Andre Berto, who just fought the other night. I'm looking forward to matching wits with him. Willie's got a lot of pressure on him, and it's not from, not so much from Gennady. He's got a lot of family pressure. His uncle, his great uncle, was one of the guys that beat Marvin, and I'm sure that he wants to emulate him. So we're looking for a real tough fight. Obviously, we're not in training camp yet. We're just beginning this tour. When we get to training camp, I'm sure Gennady will be his professional best, as he always is. We look forward to an extremely difficult fight. Southpaws are always difficult, but Gennady likes that kind of challenge. So thank you again. Thank you very much for coming out and seeing Tom. Bye-bye.
Now we'll get to the main participants and the most exciting part of the press conference. So with that, I want to bring up Matt Rowland again to introduce Willie Monroe.
Hi, it's me again. Listen, Willie Monroe, he really is a special guy. When we first came up with the foundation of Boxino, the hardest thing was to find eight guys that were willing to fight each other without knowing who their opponent's going to be. It was even more difficult to get the first two or three guys. Willie was the easiest. Signed up right away. He was actually the first participant without knowing who he's fighting, who's in the tournament, or what. And he grabbed the opportunity. Then Brian Vera came along. It was, what, 3 weeks' notice? 3 weeks' notice to fight Brian Vera. Didn't blink an eye, took the fight, and here we are today. So it was when we discussed the fight with Tom, I mean, it was shocking that they wanted to fight a left-hander. So we went to Willie, again, without hesitation. He said, that's the fight I want. I want Gennady Golovkin. So here we are, back in Los Angeles, announcing the fight. I know a lot of people out there were questionable about Willie. You know, he's an ESPN fighter, whatever that means. Very similar to the same stuff they said about Ruslan Provodnikov before he fought Tim Bradley. And now look at Provodnikov. Same attitude, he's never turned down a guy, never backed down from a fight. So without further ado, I'll let him talk, Willie Monroe.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm just blessed and elated at this opportunity. I relish opportunities, whether I'm the underdog or the favorite. And I think we have to look at the fact that nobody really wants to fight Triple G. You know, nobody. You know, you have to look. Everybody's talking about him going up to super middleweight and light heavyweight to get a fight. And I'm taking the road less travel. You know, a lot of middleweights are ducking and dodging. And I don't duck and dodge anybody. You know what I mean? I'm a champion from the inside of my heart all the way to the top of my boxing abilities. So May 16th is going down, and I'm happy that I got the opportunity, and I'm happy to be here, and I'm going to put on a good show for you guys.
With that, I want to... Okay, there we go. With that, I want to introduce... fighter that's affectionately called Triple G. Those are his real initials. It's not just something that we created. I would say, and Peter has confirmed this. He is the fastest rising fighter in the ratings on HBO, where he started in September 2012 to where he is now. He had the third highest rated show last year of anyone on the cable television. And we expect him to do bigger and better things this year. I want to acknowledge Oleg Herman, who's Gennady's manager, Oleg and Max from Germany. They're really the ones that brought Gennady to Able, and they're the ones that contacted me to work with Gennady to bring him here to the United States, and that was my promise to them that I would do my best to make him a star here in America. And the belief was, if he's a star here, it'll translate internationally, and that's really what it's come to right now. It's a family really working with Gennady, and Abel can tell you, Ole can tell you, Gennady can tell you, it's a sport, it's a business, but really on the Triple G side, it's a family, and it's special working with him, and he's a special fighter. He's accomplished many things in the ring. He's got the highest knockout streak of any active champion. One of the highest knockout streaks, or the highest knockout streak of any middleweight in the history of the sport. So with that being said, I want to introduce Gennady Triple G Golovkin.
Good afternoon, everybody. First, thank you very much for HBO and for my family, of course. You know, thank you very much for Commission, California Commission. You know, thank you very much for my team, for Monroe team, you know. Thank you for very, very support. Thank you for your support, you know, for me. Welcome to California. I live in California. I live with my family in California. Just welcome to my 16, to my home. Thank you, guys.
We want to thank everyone for coming out. Before we end the press conference, we'll have the face-off between Willie and Gennady. I do want to reiterate that the tickets start at $30, which is a tremendous value for a fight like this. And with four quality fighters, it'll be on HBO. And in addition to that, we're going to put together another great undercard of fighters, including a lot of local talent. You don't need fireworks at the press conference to have fireworks in the ring, and I think the fight and the fighters are going to sell themselves on May 16th. So with that, Bernie, we'll move the dais and we'll have the face-off.
Right here. the video one-on-ones with Harold and Simon.